tonight in the name of Jesus Christ, we're sending out the Holy Ghost arrow, and by the grace of God, that arrow is gonna shoot in the spirit. Praise God, and it's gonna hit tonight.
God will take care of you. Holiness. Hold up the banner of righteousness. Hold up the banner that we're not going to give in.
Tonight, and we're gonna give him the glory, we're gonna give him the praise.
Here on Friday night, and we toiled, we prayed, we sought the Lord, we were it's not by might, it's not by power, but it's by the Spirit, said the Lord. Praise God, and that's what we're looking to God for, that the Spirit of God will take full control. Praise God, that we can be slain in the presence of God tonight. Praise God, self is not important at this time. Praise God, when we begin to get into the presence of God, praise God, there is a difference. Praise God, there is a change in the atmosphere. Praise God, and this is what we're looking to God tonight. Praise God, when a soldier got out, praise God, when you go with, you have the special soldier, praise God, that will go out. I don't remember the name of them, but they will go out with a, and they have a specific target. Praise God, and when they have that gun and SAS, and when they point that gun at the target, that gun cannot miss. Praise God, when you have an arrow, the bow and the arrow, praise God, and you hold the arrow, praise God, and you pull the arrow back, and you set it for the target, it's that arrow have to hit. And tonight, in the name of Jesus Christ, we're sending out the Holy Ghost arrow, and by the grace of God, that arrow is going to shoot in the spirit. Praise God, and it's going to hit tonight. It's going to hit. Praise God, it cannot miss. It cannot miss. Praise God, and we just set our cups up to God tonight for a mighty outpouring, for a blessing from God. Praise God. Give God thanks in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord Jesus. The Holy Ghost power is right anyhow, right anyhow, right anyhow. The Holy Ghost power, right anyhow.
Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the Lord Jesus. Praise God. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. One more time, I give honor to the Holy Spirit of God, to our pastor, the officers, everyone that are in the house tonight. Praise God. You are God's children. Praise the name of Jesus. And we are glad to be here. Call upon the name of Jesus. And he's telling us another time that the Holy Ghost power, praise God, is right anyhow. Praise God. I may be wrong. Somebody else may be wrong. But the Holy Ghost power is right anyhow. And when I say that whatever the Holy Ghost of God says going to do, it's going to happen. Praise the name of Jesus. There's no mistake in him. So tonight, praise God, we are looking to the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. And the Holy Ghost power, oh yes, is right anyhow. And we are looking to the Holy Ghost to fall upon us tonight. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise God, people don't believe us, but it's right anyhow. Praise the name of Jesus. Some don't want to come and give God a life, but it's right anyhow. Praise the name of Jesus. Especially in a time like this, oh Lord Jesus, they should run to the Lord. But whatever we are saying, they don't believe, but it's right anyhow. Praise the name of Jesus. And we know, praise God, that the Holy Ghost is right anyhow. Praise God. And we are looking to the Lord. Name of Jesus Christ. And he'll do something special for us. Because the Holy Ghost power is right anyhow. Come, God can't be wrong. Praise God, God never wrong. He's always right. And the Holy Ghost, praise God, is God Almighty himself. So the Holy Ghost power, right anyhow. God bless you. In Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord Jesus. We come to worship tonight, brethren. Could you stand on your feet for me, please? In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We're going to worship God tonight. We're going to worship God tonight. Yes, we're going to worship God tonight. I said we're going to lose ourselves. We're going to lose. In the name of Jesus. Are we going to worship God tonight? Praise the name of Jesus. Brethren, we're going to have some testimonies. And I'm begging you, if we've never worked together before, we're going to do it tonight. Praise the name of Jesus. We're going to keep our testimony short and to the point. Because we're going to work together tonight. We need a blessing. We need a blessing. We need a blessing. So we're going to be obedient.
Day. Oh,
Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. Bedrin, me means that me come to worship, you know. Bedrin. I mean, see, I come to worship that tonight. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. So whatever satanic sabotage, whatever satanic sabotage tonight, we're going to worship, you know. We're going to praise him, you know. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. Right where you stand, lick out a prayer for me, please. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. 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 Amen. Name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we take authority in the name of Jesus. Name of Jesus. Oh, God. Name of Jesus. Name of Jesus. Name of Jesus. Jesus. Name of Jesus. Name of Jesus. He's the Holy Ghost and fire, and he's keeping me alive. Keeping me alive. Keeping me alive, he's the Holy Ghost and fire, and he's keeping me alive. Jesus is keeping me alive. He is the Holy Ghost and he's keeping me alive. Keeping me alive. Keeping me alive.
darkness. God is my all in all. God is my protection.
Reverend the Spirit of God, we to our pastor, all the officers, all the saints, greetings in Jesus' name. We just sang the song, God is my all in all. While I was there standing and singing, I was just thinking to myself that God is really my all in all. Because no matter what you go through in life, you will get instruction, you will get counseling, you will get strength, you get good advice. But you still have to turn back to God. Because there's only so far that someone can help you. And I really was thinking, and I said, God, no matter all the pain that I may feel, no matter the stress what I may go through, I still have to look to God. Because God is my all in all. And I know that only God alone can take away anything that I feel. As Brother Allen said earlier on, no matter how big the trouble or the problem may be, God is bigger than that. And I'm giving God thanks that I could be found in this house another time. Right now, I just feel good. I feel good. I feel good, brethren. I feel good. I feel good. We are the children of the Lord. And we have a right to shout and sing. Because God, our Savior, is a risen Savior. He's not a dead God. Praise the name of Jesus. Brethren, I feel good. If I never feel good, I would tell you I don't feel good. Because I love to be honest to myself. But I feel good. God is doing something in this place. And God is doing something within each and every one of us life. Prayer is the key. I realize that prayer is the key. He said, down on my knees, when trouble rise, I talk to Jesus down on my knees. I promise him that I will serve him. Praise the name of Jesus. God is a mighty God. Brethren, I don't know if you realize how the Spirit of God is moving. Even from earlier on in the morning service, the Spirit of God was just searching the heart. Searching the heart. Searching the heart. Because he wants to fill somebody. He wants to pour out his Spirit upon somebody. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. Brethren, I feel good. I feel good. I feel good. Praise the name of Jesus. And I know you feel good. And I know that is because it's the mercies of God. Brethren, sometimes I try to think about the goodness of Jesus. And the natural mind cannot comprehend it. Because it's too deeper than that. But I give God thanks for his kindness. And I give God thanks for his mercies. Brethren, I feel good, brethren. Praise the name of Jesus. I don't know what's ahead. But while I feel good, I'm going to feel good. Praise the name of Jesus. And even when trouble rises, I'm still going to pray to the Almighty God. Because he's given us the power. Praise the name of Jesus. When I think about the God that we serve, that created the human being, we got eyes, we got nose, we got mouth, we got hands, we got feet, we got our heart, we got our lungs, we got our kidney, we got our liver, we got our intestine. The God that made night different from day, the God that made the sea different from the land. Praise the name of Jesus. That's the God who we serve. Rich and I feel good. And I just want to humble myself before God. God wants to do a mighty work. Praise the name of Jesus. Because his name must be exalted. Not just only in this building, but all over the world. Praise the name of Jesus. Just let your heart open up. That's all it takes. Open your heart. Right now as you are here standing, sitting, just deny yourself. Deny yourself. Brethren, before I take my seat, earlier on I was thinking, a thought came back to my mind. And this was before I got saved. So I was walking through there and You know, Sister Rose, she came and she stood in front of me. You know, at that time, I was a little bit like, I had my temper and I was weary of everyone, you know? So when she came and stood in front of me, I stood defensively. And that was just me at the time. But Sister Rose, I'll never forget this. She stopped me and she said, God have a blessing for you. But you need to take yourself out of the way. It came back to me. You can't be in the way and expect God to come in the way. You have to take yourself out of the way, and then that's when God come in now. Praise the name of Jesus. You have to deny yourself. You have to give up yourself. You have to surrender. You have to submit to God. But brethren, these are my few words. Praise the name of Jesus. God is going to do something mightily. He's going to do something mighty. The prayers are not in vain. All these services, they are not in vain. And I know that prayer has been going up before I was born. Praise the name of Jesus. But God is shifting things. God is taking us out of custom. God is changing our mind. God is reminding us how powerful He is. Supreme in power and authority. That's the God whom we serve. Praise the name of Jesus. It's like I want to sit down and it's like I can't stop. But just, Bridget, God is good, Bridget. God is good. God is a mighty God. I mean, when Brother Michael stood up earlier on, I just said in my heart, I said, God, let him continue to speak. Just let him continue to speak. Because just by him continuing to speak, something can burst with inside of him. But that's how the Spirit of God moves. Just speak. Just let the Spirit move. That's why I love that song. It said, my brothers and sisters, let the Spirit move. When things go wrong, and the way, praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. As I look at my dear sister Karen earlier on, I just singing the song and said, why worry when you can pray? Why worry when you can pray? Praise the name of Jesus. Don't be like doubtful Thomas. Put your faith and trust in Jesus. Why worry when you can pray? If you're in here tonight and you're not saved, I just want to tell you that Jesus loves and cares for you. Because when he came, he did not come to die for Christians or just for the righteous. He came for the whole entire world. So I just want to tell you that Jesus loves you. And you are here for a purpose. You could have been somewhere else, but God wanted you to be here tonight. Give Jesus a chance in your life. And you will see the difference in your life. Praise the name of Jesus. Because we serve a risen Savior. And he's mighty to save. You pray my strength in Jesus' name.
Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. I'm going to ask the general choir to come back. We have two visitors that walk in here tonight. Heard us singing. And they're requesting if we could sing this song again for them. We're going to do it for you. God bless you. God bless you. You're welcome. And I pray that as we sing, that God will touch you. Praise the name of Jesus. I pray that God will do something mighty for you. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. Can our two visitors stand? Can you stand? We want to welcome you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Praise the name of Jesus. And may your soul be blessed as we sing to God's honor and glory. In Jesus' name.
One day I came to him. I was so thirsty. I know.
Jesus, in his great thirst, he brought water to me. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. In his great thirst, he brought water to me.
Shall I pray the Lord Jesus? Shall I pray the Lord Jesus? Give God thanks, great pastor, saints of God, wonderful name of Jesus. Give God thanks for spreading my life to be here. He first, he brought water to me. I was saying this song, I was thinking about how he came and was a human being. We talk about God, 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 but forget, he put on flesh, just like what we have. Exactly the same, but it was sinless flesh. He failed every pain. He had headache, hungry, backache. Everything that we're going through, he felt it just like us.
Amen.
The mighty God became a man to experience hunger. Although he was God, he was hunger. Although he was God, he was tired.
Amen.
Although he was God, he was weary. Although he was God, he was thirsty. And he put on all that experience to us so that we can be felt with his compassion, his pain. And I said, God, thank you, Lord, because he became like us. He was tempted, yet he didn't sin. He was a man on earth. You know, this is my revelation, right? My revelation, Virgin. 2 minutes more, right? My revelation. This is my revelation. He was a baby saying, mama, mama, mama. They had to carry him in his hand, remember? Because Joseph carried him to Egypt, right? He couldn't walk. He was an infant, baby-like toddler. They were not different from any other baby. He grew up to obey his parents. You follow me? He done everything as we would have done. But when he reached 30 years old, he revealed himself that he's the Messiah.
Amen.
But he still, the flesh was just like our flesh.
Yes.
So what you're going through, he knows.
Yes.
So you don't need to give up and backslide and say, God understood. God knows.
Yes.
He felt it. He know it. So we have no excuse. We have no excuse, brethren.
Amen.
We can't say, oh, it was God. It became a man. So all what we're going through, every part of our life, our testing, our troubles, our headaches, he knows it.
Yes.
So I can't say, God, you don't understand. God understands, and he knows what you're going through right now.
Amen.
The pain you're carrying in your heart, the loneliness, the heartache, the rejection, all that he had experienced it.
Yes.
But he says, whatever you have, come to me.
All
your labor and heavy laden, all your burdens of life, all your rejection, you've been thrown out by your husband, your wife, your kids, everybody rejects you. He says, he had that experience too.
Yes.
There's nothing that a human being has been through that he had not experienced it.
Amen.
He loved the people so much, done so much miracle for them,
yes.
Healed the sick, raised the dead.
Amen.
The same people say, crucify him, get rid of him. You could do good for people, all your heart desire to help them.
Yes.
The same people turn against you and get rid of you.
Amen.
It happened to him.
Yes.
So be of good courage, brethren.
Yes.
He was bruised, was beaten.
Yes.
You know, give me one more minute, please, yeah? When you get beaten with a stick, beat, your shoulder get sore, don't it?
Amen.
This, you get the pain. The bruise and when they carried the cross from Calvary, it was a heavy cross, and they carried it, yeah? And they don't just say to him, slap in the face, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. They give him some beating, and they kicked him, and they bruised him. And they got this tool, it's like a rake, with prongs of metal in it. And when they hit you with it on your back, they pull it, and it tears all your flesh from your back. Rip your back to bits. And they beat him so much that he was weak and his face could not move.
Jesus.
He couldn't carry the cross no more. He was beat so much.
Amen.
That he dropped.
Jesus.
And then the man had to take it up and carry for him.
Mm.
And on the cross, they put him on this cross. That the nails, I saw nails, which I don't know if it's true. The Vatican couldn't have the nails. They're about 12 inches long. The Vatican couldn't have the nails, you know.
Yeah.
That Vatican, Roman Catholic Vatican, have a lot of things they hide, you know. They have the nails what Jesus crucified with. They have it there, you know. This long. The nails was this long. Big nails that long. They put his hand like this, and they drive it in, you know, in here, in your hand, middle here. You have a nerve here, you know, a main nerve, a blood nerve in your hand that makes your hand function. They drive it into the nervous system. The nerve and the hand do this. The feet cross. Double feet. The long nail, they drive it between two bones. Breaking the bone, not the bone, not the bone, the tendency. Because no bones are broken, eh? The flesh, go through the flesh, through the nerves. And when that was not enough, they get a sword and not just cut, pierce his side and push it in like this. And cut up the inside of his belly. And out of the belly come water and blood. A fountain filled with blood. Drawn from a man's will. That was a price to pay for sin. Ultimate price paid for our redemption tonight. So I'm not here just to be happy, happy. I'm here to say, thank you, Lord, for paying that price to set me free. And I'm going to stay free. You stay free too, in Jesus' name.
Praise the name of Jesus. He went through all that for you and me. Can't we not give him glory? Can't we not thank him? Can we not adore him? Because he's been a good God. Praise the name of Jesus. Bless your name, Jesus.
Praise God. Praise the Lord, church. Praise God. Give honor to the Spirit of God. I greet my pastor, evangelist, minister, all the saints, visiting friend in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise God. I'm feeling so good today. You know, even from the prayer that we had, the late night prayer on Friday, leading up to today, and God has been really working among us. You know, and this song just came to my heart. Oh, I want to see him. Just to look upon his face. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. I just want to see Jesus. I want to see him someday. Praise God. And I don't want my singing to be in vain. I don't want my living to be in vain. I don't want my praying, my fasting, coming to church to be in vain, because I want to see Jesus someday. Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. As I journey through this land, singing as I go, pointing souls to Calvary, to the Prince of Glory. Many arrows have my soul from without within, but my Lord leads me on through him I must win. Thank you.
Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. Oh, I want to see him. Praise the Lord Jesus. Keep standing, brethren. Keep standing. Praise the name of Jesus. Oh, I want to see him. I want to see Jesus. I want to see Jesus. Praise the Lord Jesus. Oh, I want to see him. Praise the name of Jesus. It's an individual, you know. The songwriter said, I. Praise the name of Jesus. Jesus said, in the congregation, ma'am, there's wheat and tears. So if the wheat and the tears, you must know where you fall. So that's why the songwriter said, I. Because he knows his heart. He knows who he believe. He know who he's serving. So he said, I want to see him. Praise the name of Jesus. So you must know to say, oh, I want to see him. After what our minister says, the nails that they put through him, the thorns they put on his head, the pierced his side, and it was for me. Oh, yes, I want to see him. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. At this time, our preacher for the night is going to be Minister Pike to the church. Praise the name of Jesus. And we're going to ask God to anoint him. In the name of Jesus, we're going to ask God to step inside him. Praise the name of Jesus. That whatever God have him to say to us, may we receive it and may we do what God say. Minister Pike to the church. In Jesus' name. Praise the Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord Jesus.
Jesus, praise God. First, we must give honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Greet my pastor Ian Douglas, minister, evangelist, all the sweet saints of God. I greet you all in Jesus' name. The reason why I can greet you like this tonight is because there's no other name under heaven where I can greet you by than the name of Jesus Christ. There's no other name that can save. There's no other name that can heal. No other name that can deliver. No other name that can set free.
Amen.
Praise the Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord Jesus. I don't have a word, but I just have a song. Praise God. I just pray that I can sing this song to the glory of God in Jesus' name. It was on me last week, and I was singing it to myself. And then I came today, and I heard the message from Brother Allen, and I was saying, okay, I'm going to try to sing this song. Praise the Lord Jesus. It says, God will take care of you.
Yes.
Praise the Lord Jesus. Be not dismayed. But there be times. God will take care of you.
Amen.
Can you put the words up for me, please? Praise the name of Jesus. Because there's this. Nobody else can do what God can do. There is no other power that can save. There is no other power that can deliver. Praise the Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord Jesus. The time we're living in now is a serious time. It is a very deadly time that we're living in. And the reason why we're living in such a time is because if we go back a few years, I don't know what it was like before I came here, but when I came here, they used to have devotions.
Yes.
You used to be able to pray in the hospital.
Yes.
You could still pray in the school.
Yes.
But they've taken all that away. And when you take God away, you're left with one thing.
Amen.
When you take away the protection, you open up to any and everything. So we are at a time now where they've taken God out of the schools. They've taken God out of the hospital. They've taken God out of everywhere. Out of the home. And if you're not careful, they try to take God out.
we are open up to any and everything. But thank God there's a remnant. Thank God there is a remnant. They tried to kill out the seed royal. Now, if you are king and your heir is your son. Now, if the first son dies, you have another son. So your name continues. But if the first son don't have a son, and the brother don't have a son, and they both die, then the bloodline is lost. They try to cut out the seed right by killing all the brothers. But there is a protection around. They've taken God out of everything, but there is a people that God has prepared to carry on his name. This will never die. God's word shall never die. Why won't it die? Because it was bought by blood. Yes. It took blood to shed on Calvary, so that tonight we can have access to the throne of grace. God will take care of you. God will take care of you. Time we're living in, you've been pressured on every hand. You go to work, you're pressured, and we know what we're talking about. When you're in the schools, you've been pressured. You work in the nursing home, you've been pressured. Wherever you go, there is pressure on every hand. But stand fast in the liberty. Stand fast. Hold your ground. No retreat. No surrender. But when you're down to your last dime, God will make a way. The child was dead. The child, life had gone. They send for the prophet. Showing you God will always make a way. She thought that this is it now. The one navel string gone. But God will make a way. Don't be discouraged. Don't be dismayed. Yes, sometimes you will feel like when we see the walls of fire, we will feel like we're all on our own. Jeremiah felt like he was on his own. Sometimes you will feel like you're all alone. Sometimes you pray, and it feels like a prayer is not bursting through. Sometimes you fast, and it feels like you're wasting your time. But God is coming. Help is coming. Help is on the way. Can't remember exactly where the scriptures, but when they prophet felt trouble, and there was war going on, and all he could see was the enemies around him. He couldn't see no help from anywhere. But when God opened
seven eyes,
so your enemies around you, but those around them. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God will take care of you. God will take care of you. Reason why it says no retreat, no surrender, is because we've got to know what our profession is.
Amen.
There was a film I watched some years back. I think I gave this testimony before. And there was an army, Persian army, was coming up against the Spartans. And what he did, what the king did, he only took 300 of his best soldiers, going up an army of hundreds of thousands. But in their heart, everybody knows what their position is. Everybody knew what they were fighting for. So he met upon some other soldiers who was going to fight as well. And one, the leader of the other army says, your army is bigger than this. Why you only bring 300 men? So the king asks them, what is your profession? What do you do for a living? One says, I'm a blacksmith. Another one says, I'm a carpenter.
Yes.
They were all different professions.
Yes.
Then he turned to his army and he says, what is your profession? And one of the 300 gave a shout.
Amen.
What I took from that is they knew what they were fighting for.
Yes.
They knew they were fighting for their integrity.
Yes.
They knew they were fighting for holiness.
Yes.
We know we are fighting for righteousness.
Yes.
We will not back down
no. To
the devil.
No.
Because he's going to creep in,
yes. Try
to creep in
yes. Unaware. Yes.
And this is what the government has been trying to do.
Amen.
Is creeping unaware.
Amen.
They do things to say, yes, this is in your favor. But when you get caught in their trap, it's hard to get out.
Amen.
So I'm saying to us tonight, God will take care of us. But hold on to your profession. Hold on to what you believe in. If you don't believe in anything, believe something and hold on to it. And the just shall live by faith, not by our strong will, not by our know-how, not by our, because sometimes, because we may fast one day or 2 days, we think we're on the mountain top of holiness. But what we've got to understand, that is after the fasting, extra fight is coming.
Yes.
For when Jesus himself fasted,
yes,
the body, we understand that yes, he's Jesus. Yes, he's God.
Yes.
But what he did was he put on flesh so we can be touched by the feeling. Praise the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
So the body itself felt pain.
Yes.
The body itself got hungry after 40 days of fasting. And as he finished the fasting, here comes the devil. When we do some fasting, expect the fight. Our pastor always tells us, look for storm. Look for wind. Look for rain. You've got to be prepared. Hold fast to your profession. When you hold fast to your profession, help will come.
Amen.
When you hold fast to your profession, the great commander in chief will send his armies. That's why the righteous say, hold the fort, for I am coming. Hold the fort. The fight is on, but be not weary. Be strong. It is my turn fast. It's God for us. Praise the Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord Jesus. Hold fast, because the fight is on. Years we've been singing this song. We're soldiers in the army. We've got to fight, though we have to cry. But even in that, we've got to hold up the bloodstained banner. Hold up the banner of holiness. Hold up the banner of righteousness. Hold up the banner that we're not going to give in. Because they're trying to water down the gospel. The gospel that saves. The gospel that heals. The gospel that delivers. The gospel that set free. It's been watering down. But thank God, there's a remnant in heaven. Thank God that there's a remnant over this side that is standing on the word, that is standing in holiness. Praise the Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. We're going to stand. We're going to stand the fight. We have to stand the fight. We've got to stand the fight. We've got to stand the fight. The writer caught the vision. He caught the vision and says, give me peace in the midst of the storm. It has to come. A testimony. Some years back, I was struggling with something. And I was crying and I was praying. At one time, I started to complain to God. Because I said, God, why this have to happen? Why do I have to go through this? Why does this have to come? We get there many times. And I remember I came to church. And my pastor, she was expounding the word. She brought us back. Well, she brought me back. She didn't say Kevin, but she was talking to me because I'm the one who needed the prayer. She was saying that the three Hebrew boys went in the fire. And God was in there with them. He could have stopped them from going in, but he had to show his power. She said, Daniel went in the den of lions, and God was in there with him. God could have stopped him from going there, but he went in there. So sometimes we've got to go in it for God to take us out of it. He's all powerful. He's almighty. He's all excellent. There is none to compare to his might and power. So hold on. Be strong. Be strong. Hold to your profession. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. When you go to work, hold on. When you're at school, hold on. When you're on the street, hold on. Hold to your profession. But when you hold to your profession, the deliverer. God will take care of you. God will take care of you. If God can feed his servant with manna from above, from a raven, we've heard the explanation. explanation.
Amen.
Because it was before my time. That pastor explained that the, was it two plates for a pardon?
Yes.
Now she explained what a pardon was.
Yes.
A penny cut in half. His eyes.
He's
on the spiral. God is good.
Jesus.
God is good.
No,
God is good.
No.
It's good sometimes to watch wildlife program.
Yes.
Because sometimes it will, because everybody learns differently.
Yes.
Sometimes when you see it, it will click to you what a mighty God we serve.
Yes.
Because he this animal feeds that one. That animal, there is a chain that follows. So when you see one animal kill another, whatever is left, it's not just that it nourishes the ground. I saw once in a program about the rainforest. And they were showing that this animal can't climb, can't fly, and the nuts he eats is from one of the biggest trees in the rainforest. And they were explaining
the part that was.
Thank you very much. Praise God. When the monkey climbs the tree, they pick what they don't want, they drop it. That animal comes, they eat that. Now, sometimes what they do, they say what they do when they have too much, they will hide it. So they will go all over, dig up the ground, and hide it for another time. But they forget that it's there, and the trees start to grow. So it's not like human beings going in the rainforest, but God is working his miracle. He will take care of you. And if you're weak and feeling a bit doubtful, all you have to do is be true to him. Say, God, I am weak. I'm feeling pressured and I don't know what to do. And he will take care of you. Hold fast to your profession. Hold fast to your belief. Hold fast to the gospel of Jesus Christ. Repentance and baptism in the name of Jesus Christ. Hold fast to what you believe. They will have to rock the ship. The ship will be rocky.
Yes.
The only time you see a ship is not rocking is in the lowest of low tide.
Yes.
But even that, the wave is still going and the ship is still.
Amen.
But there are times when the tide is high and the waves are coming from every angle. And the waves are very high.
Yes.
But stay on board.
Yes.
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 All the protection is when you stay on board.
Yes.
Anything outside, we'll look at the ark. Everything that was inside was saved. Everything on the outside was destroyed. Stay on board and hold fast to your profession in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord Jesus. Minister said, God will take care of you. Praise the name of Jesus. Can we stand? Anybody need prayer, you can come as we sing that song. God will take care of you through every day, all the way. He will take care of you. God will take care of you. God will take
to protect us. The fight is on, the virus is out there.
The virus to attack your spirit is there. You need to come and talk to God and tell God from your heart to renew it or give you extension or some grace, some mercy, some protection. Only what he can offer. The church here can't offer you nothing. We here can't offer you nothing at all. Only God can offer the protection, and he sent you tonight. Come that you can stand before him and look, they can look in your face and grant you mercy, protection. That's the voice of God speaking to you tonight. You're going to pray yourself and talk to God and renew your talk to him in your heart. Simple as that. It's not hard work. We're not throwing stone, but God's saying, you need it. You need it. You're going to pray, all pray to God and tell God to renew your, to protect you. Renew it yourself, your prescription, renew it. This is not only for Christians. Those who are baptized, those who are not saved yet, you are God's child. God made you. You belong to him. He runs your life, not you run your life. He runs your life. And as they pray now, we're going to lead them in God's hands. They come to God, we lead them in God's hands. I've done my part. It's open. If you feel like your protection has expired, you need to renew it. If you don't renew your computer, what happened to it? It break down. The virus take it and take all your files, all your documents, steal it. All your hard work wiped out. Because you had no protection. And update just went on it. Every now and then, they're bringing a new program to greater fight the viruses. Because the viruses get so technical, no? The virus gets so harder. So you have to keep upgrading. So that's a spiritual message to the church and to those who are not saved. Come to God, talk to him to renew your protection. God don't force it on nobody. You will come to him. He that come to him, he would not cast you out. Amen. May God bless you. That's what I have to say. In Jesus' name.
Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him. How I have proved him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, praise.